Hello guys, on this video I'm going to show you how to add a preset using Lightroom. So let's get started. I'm going to take this picture. So in the meantime guys, the preset I'm going to show you, it's commonly known as a filter close-up, but I prefer to call it Keep Preset. Then we're going to go to our lights, then go to the curves, try to make your points look as similar to mine as possible as you can. So yeah. Let's just redo this. Okay, there we go. So let's go to our reds. Same thing as the blues. Okay, there. So we're going to adjust our export to negative 80. Then our contrast to positive 20. Then we skip the highlights, the shadows to positive 65. Then our whites to negative 100. Then our blacks to negative 15. Then we're going to color our temp to positive 20. Then our tint to 2, our vibrance to negative 25. Then we go to mixture, we leave the hues untouched, so the saturation will be negative 40. And the luminance will be negative 20. Then we go to orange, our hues negative 5. Our saturation to negative 5. Our luminance positive 20. Then we go to the yellow, our saturation negative 100. Then go to the green, same thing, our saturation to negative 100. Then we go to light blue, our saturation negative 100. Then we go to blue, saturation negative 100. The pink, purple, saturation negative 100. Then the pink, saturation negative 100. Then we are done for the mixture. Then you go to a texture, go to speed tone, so our speed tone for the highlight is going to be 243 and our saturation to 28. So mine may take longer because it's clustered in under one thing, so yours may be separated the hues and the highlights. So yeah, it's very difficult to get exactly the same numbers as maybe yours could maybe do it. So yeah, let's see. Okay. Nah. Okay. I'm just going to leave it like that. So, let me adjust a little bit. So. Okay, we're going to our shadows, same thing. Then for our highlights, we're going to adjust it to 242, then our saturation to 27. Okay, we're done with the highlights, so let's go to our shadows, as I've said, to make it to 242 and our saturation to 27. So we're done, we go to our details, sharply to 23. Then we go to noise reduction, on detail. Then on color noise reduction to 28. Then we are done with the first preset. So we are going to take the same photo that we just did right now, then overlay it with another preset. So I'm going to save this one. Then I'm going to take it again, re-edit it as it is. So I'm going to add that picture again. So it may take a little bit longer. It's taking longer than I thought, so let's just wait for it. Okay, thank you for your patience, guys. So we are going to take that picture we just edited. There it is. So I'm gonna edit again. Yeah, let's just wait for it to reappear. As you can see, these are some of the presets I've already done. Yeah. So, here we go. We click on that picture. Same thing. We're going to go to our lights. No curves this time, just adjust the exposure to negative any line. Then our contrast to negative 50. Then our highlights to negative 63. Then our shadows to positive 44. Then our whites to negative 21. Then our blacks to negative 17. We are going to go to the color. So go to mixture. Adjust the hues to negative 27. That's it, 34. Then our tilt to negative 24. Then our vibrance to negative 7. Then our saturation to positive 52. As you can see, the picture is already starting to change. Then we go to our mixture. We'll use negative 27. Then our saturation to 25, negative 25. Then we leave the luminance alone, go to the next color, which is orange, leave the hues alone, and our saturation is positive 31. Then our luminance is positive 57. They'll go to yellow if the hues are low, so our saturation is negative 59 for the hues, I mean. Then our saturation would be negative 92. Then our luminance is positive 72. Then we go to the grills. Then we go to the grills. Our hues are negative 33. Then saturation negative 86. Then our luminance is going to be positive 69. Look at that picture we got now. Wow. So that's not just the end of it. So let's wait until we finish and see the results we get. So for our saturation, it's going to be negative 68, as I said. 86. Then our luminance is going to be positive 69. Then we go to light blue. Same thing, hues negative 33. Then our luminance is going to be negative. Saturation is going to be negative 86. Then our luminance is going to be positive 69. Okay, there we go. So luminance, positive 69. There we go, so we go to blue. Our hues 92, positive 92. Then our saturation, positive 47. Then our luminance, positive 73. then we go to purple or saturation negative 93. Saturation negative 90 for the pins. We are done with the mixture. We go to our texture. Then we go to split tone. So for the highlights, guys, it's going to be 223 and saturation at 59. So, as I told you before, mine is quite complicated getting the same exact point. So, I'm just going to try and see if I get. So, yeah. Then we're going to move to our shadows, our hues at 238 and saturation at 43. For the noise reduction, it's going to be 12. Noise reduction at 12. Then our color construct at 7, then our color noise or the reduction at 40, color noise reduction at 14, so I'm just going to decrease the saturation in color a little bit. Just to decrease the yellowish color. So, perfect. Thank you for watching this video, guys. And I hope you like it. And, yeah. So, I hope you like it. And I hope you can get it well. And, please, don't forget to subscribe. Taras.